We are recording. That is good. We are recording. Perfect. Oh boy, this is so nerve-wracking. This is an incredibly nerve-wracking experience. Oh, people are coming in. That is good. Hello. We will not start until 8 o'clock on the dot. 8 o'clock on the dot is when we will start. But, you know, I figured start the space 5 minutes early. Let people get in. Let people get settled. Let, you know, go use the bathroom. Go get your water. Go call your mom. If you have a mom, go ahead and call her. You know, you got time. You know, it's going to be a long night. So please use the bathroom. Get a drink of water. Do what you have to do. We're just waiting. We're going to start roughly at 5 o'clock, what am I saying? Roughly at 8 o'clock today. Hope everybody's doing good today. Got a lot of people coming in already. This is nerve-wracking. I've had a very busy and wild day, and it's just, oof, so many people listening. This is going to be wild. Did you see that we were trending? Did people, the Muppet Twitter Awards were trending, which was wild. I would not be surprised if I get a message being like, hey, did you know you're number one on spaces right now? I would not be surprised if that happens. How do I share a space? I just need to share. I need to do now. Okay, retweet the thing. Oof. Good. Yeah, actually, undo my retweet and do a quote tweet. Oh, no, I don't want to see quote. Okay. We are live. Hashtag, all caps for some reason. Muppet Twitter Awards. Okay, so we're a few minutes away, so while we wait, please enjoy this wonderful music. This is our preview music. When this music ends, the awards will start. So as soon as this song ends, the awards will start. Somebody could give me a thumbs up to say, somebody just give me a thumbs up emoji that the music sounds at a decent volume. Somebody let me know that they can hear the music and it's not too loud. Okay, good. Thank you, everybody. Once this song ends, we're going to get into our opening, and it's going to be incredible. And we have a wonderful show lined up for you today. If you're curious, this is the end credit theme from Muppets Most Wanted, composed by Christopher Beck. Christopher Beck, great composer, did a lot of Marvel stuff and Frozen. Doo-doo. We will start exactly at 8 o'clock. I see a lot of our nominees and presenters are already here, so I'm very excited for them and other people coming in to listen. Do, do, do. We will start in roughly 10 seconds. Just a note, if you are a presenter tonight or a winner tonight and you need to speak, you must be on a phone. Tablets and other devices do not work. To speak in a space, you must be on a phone. And without that, here we go. Live via Twitter Spaces, It's the second annual Muppet Twitter Awards with special guests Mathew Gaydos, Sam Schultz, David Levy, Adam Grossworth, Jade Turner, Carrie Priebus, Justin Priebus, Richard Michael Gomez, Emily Engel, Christio, Mary, B, Kim, Sam Allen, Karsten, Amie, Joe Hennis, Ryan Rowe, Beth Cook, Mathew Sobermen, Shane Keating, JD Hansel, with special appearances by Mel, Holly Jones, the Muppet Wiki, plus several surprise special guests. Now, please welcome your host for the evening, Tori!
Thank you, and, thank you. Now, firstly, a warm welcome to the people in the back, and secondly, welcome to the second annual Muppet Twitter Awards. To start us off right, I'm inviting somebody to speak now. Agree to that invite. To start us off right, please enjoy this musical performance from five-time Muppie nominee Richard Michael Gomez.
Howdy. I wrote a little song just for all of you, and now I'm a bit more intimidated, but I'll try not to mess up. So here goes nothing. I'd like to take a moment to tell you that you're swell. It means an awful lot to me to say I know some of you well. Even if not all of us received a nomination, you've made this space a better place. You deserve a celebration. So, Mathew and Sam and David and Adam and Christy and Micheal have kept me awake for Kermit's sake through so many long halls. Becca kept me guessing while Jade, Emma, and Louis were impressing me with a Muppetsational show. And of course I have to mention Joe, Ryan, and Smig, Jared, Julia, Anthony, that's right, I mean tough pigs. Ryan, Stacy, Beth, and JD, there's much talent that it's crazy, Mathew, Shane, and Maria, too. Oh, Karsten, and Christy, and Nico, and Iffy, blow me away with their stuff. Moomin, and Freddy, and Brody, and Emily, I honestly can't get enough. Oh, Amie, Angie, Mary, Nova, Sam, Josh, Kim, and B. How people I can call my friends, and that just tickles me. We've got a cast of personalities that I suspect, if I may speak quite candidly, make this a better place to be. Make this a better place to be. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey.
Thank you so much, Richard. And once again, hello to everyone and welcome to the second annual Muppet Twitter Awards. Oh, hold on. I forgot something. The Muppet Twitter Awards are brought to you by The Muppets No Context. We've got a large amount of new voters this year. Unfortunately, we don't know who they voted for because their ballots just say bawk, 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 bawk. But in all seriousness, last year we had 419 votes, and this year we have 689, which is way more than two. And that's not even including the spam votes I had to remove last night. This is, of course, a live event, but it is being recorded, so it will last forever. Well, at least until HBO Max decides to take it down so they have to stop paying me residuals. All right, now let's get ready for all the boring jargon, folks. Please note that there will be technical issues tonight, but I will do my best to solve those as they come up. Also, please try to keep the language to a PG-13 tonight. I want to keep this a family-friendly event. And if you win tonight, please send me a request, and I will make you a speaker so you will have your moment. And when it is your turn to present, please send me a request, and I will make you a speaker. And if I didn't make this clear earlier, presenters, please read all the nominees and then the winner. We have so many great presenters here tonight, and we happen to have them from people from all over the world. The United States, Canada, Missoula, the UK, and wherever Jared is from. My one hope this year is that nobody gets murdered by a Muppet live at the awards, which you think I wouldn't have to worry about, but it happened last year, so who knows, maybe it'll happen again this year. You know what? Why not start with a bang? A special guest, perhaps. May you please welcome back to the Muppy space. I'm waiting for them to accept the request. I told you. Technical difficulties. They accepted the request. Great. Please welcome back to the Muppy space, Muppet Babies, supervising director, and Emmy Award-winning voice actor of Baby Kermit, Matt Danner.
Yay! Hi-ho, everybody, and thanks for having me back to the second annual Muppet Twitter Awards. I'm very excited to be here and read the first category, which is the Muppet Fan Artist of the Year, which I'm very excited to announce because I love seeing all your work on Twitter and other places. But, you know, as someone who is a Muppet fan myself and who eventually got to, you know, work with the Muppets and be a Muppet, it's a wonderful thing. So I'm very, very excited to read this award. So Baby Kermit's a little sick today, but I'll see if I can get him to read off the nominees here. So hi-ho, everybody. This is Baby Kermit the Frog. Yay! And I'm here to read the nominees for Muppet Fan Artist of the Year. The nominees are Richard Michael Gomez, Starman's Art. Emily Engel, BX Personified. Christopher Smigliano. Straw Birdie, Your Friend Bird. Nico G, NG5132. Sounds like a robot. Christy O, KO Makes Things. Freddy, Skill Battle. And Iffy, B. Artney. I believe that's how you pronounce it, B. Artney. And without further ado, the Muppy goes to Richard Michael Gomez, Starman's Art. Yay! Congrats.
Should I be speaking or
yes,
not?
Yes, go, Richard, go.
Okay.
Go nuts, man.
I didn't have a speech prepared. I didn't plan this well. I'd like to thank all the little elves in my workshop that do everything for me. I haven't used my hands in 5 years. but seriously, thank you so much. Yay!
Congrats, buddy.
Yay, thank you.
And congrats to Richard for that wonderful word. And thank you, Matt, for coming to speak tonight.
I appreciate it. And I do apologize. I have an engagement tonight, so I cannot sit with you all for the rest of the awards, which I would love to do. So thank you for recording it because I am going to listen to it as soon as I'm home. But good luck to all
thank
of you.
Thank you so much, Matt. Have a lovely night.
And thank you. See ya.
That's great. Thank you so much. fun fact, actually, Matt presented the first award last year. So, you know, it's like tradition now. It's a weird tradition, but it is indeed tradition. By the way, just so everybody knows, this show should run about an hour and a half. We're just gonna cheeky snappy, but let's see what happens. But enough muppeting around. Why don't we get things started with our second presenter? I have no idea how we got this person. He is a Grammy Award-winning artist and a freaking Beatle. Please give a warm welcome to the best drummer in rock and roll, Ringo Starr! What's that? He's not coming. He sent me a restraining order? Well, what am I going to... Oh, he sent a replacement? Well, who'd he send? one of the hosts of Muppet Fans Talking and the person who mixes up Ludo and Thog? All right, please welcome Mary and B.
Hello, hello, everyone.
Hi, it's an honor to be calling in for Mr. Spar.
Absolutely, it is an honor, and somehow, hopefully, we can make this right.
As a Muppet podcaster and a fan of Muppet podcasts myself, this is a category very near and dear to my heart. Because the podcast is more than itself. It's the people we have on it.
As one of the people who have been on your Muppet podcast, I can agree.
All right. I'm just pulling this up. The nominees, the nominees for best guests on a Muppet-themed podcast are...
Mathew Gaydos and Sam Schultz from Muppeturgy.
Abby Sommer, Muppet Profiles.
J.D. Hansel, live from Muppetland.
Mathew Soberman, Moving Right Along.
Jared Faircloth, Moving Right Along.
Iffy, Hubba Wah.
Dave Goles, Fraggle Talks.
And Warwick Brownlow Pike, Muppetational.
And the winner of this Dear Muppy is Dave Goles for Fraggle Talks.
Victoria, is Dave Goles here?
No.
I was going to say, we didn't get Ringo, but did we get Dave?
No, Dave Goles is not here. But I'm sure if he was, he would be very grateful for this award. And
absolutely.
Thank you two for presenting tonight.
Absolutely. Thank you, Tori.
Also, I should mention that
at
any point tonight, if somebody needs to say, hubba wah, they have to do it in the voice. Just fair warning.
Got it. I'm sorry if I wasn't enthusiastic.
No,
noted for next time.
You were great. All right.
Awesome.
Thank you two. So, as you may know, I announced most of our presenters earlier today, but our next presenter is one who I kept secret until now. This presenter is also one of the few who sadly couldn't be here tonight live, but was kind enough to send a pre-recorded message. So please welcome Junior Gorg himself, Dan Garza! Oh, I gotta play that. There we go.
Hey folks, it's me, Dan Garza, and I'm sorry I couldn't be there live, but I still wanted to show my support by presenting here at the Muppet Twitter Awards via this wonderful, thoughtful, dare I say, entertaining, pre-recorded message. I'm here to present to you the award for the most hyped upcoming prediction. And the nominees are The Muppets Mayhem, Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock, Season 2, the physical version of Beyond the Mayhem fanzine, Ron Howard's Jim Henson documentary, untitled Sesame Street movie, Richard Gomez's next puppet, and the Muppy goes to The Muppets Mayhem. Congratulations. And now, back to the live Muppet Twitter Awards. Have fun.
Thank you, Dan, for sending in that wonderful pre-recorded message. I'm sure the team behind the Muppets Mayhem would be very excited if they, about this award. Let's see. What's next? Oh, this person. F. I think we have somebody who wants to say something real quick. Let me see if they want to say something. Yes, would you like to say something? Yes, I can hear you.
All right. Can I say a quick thank you?
Yes.
On behalf.
Who are you, good sir?
Oh, sorry. I'm Jeff York. I'm one of the co-creators of Muppets Mayhem.
Oh my goodness.
Am I on? Can everyone hear me right now?
Yep, we can hear you.
Very cool. I think we won for most hyped upcoming prediction or production. I'm not
production.
Entirely sure.
Production.
But like prediction, but I just want to say thank you, guys. First of all, you should all know I'm a huge Muppet fan, first and foremost. Being able to make the show has been an absolute dream come true. We're super psyched for everyone to see the show. We have no idea when. But it's been an absolute labor of love, a total blast to make, and we made it for you guys. So we hope you guys love it. Thank you again.
Well, thank you so much.
Okay, so I'm just gonna, yep, for now. Okay, and so our next presenter, thanks again, Jeff, for accepting that award. That was great. Our next presenter is a three-time nominee tonight and the curator behind the highly successful Muppets No Context. Please welcome Tori! Oh, thank you, Tori. I am very glad to be here and to read out the nominees for Best Account Under 1,000 Followers. And the nominees are J.D. Hansel at JD11PC. Out of Context Fraggle Rockers at OOC Fraggle GC. Kim at Kermiggy. Puppet Girls Daily at Puppet Girl OTD. Bear Music Machine at The Big Blue Bot. Gav at Gavry3. Kuzbanian Zygon at Pig's Laundry. And Moomin slash Hup at URDUPE. And the Muppy goes to Kim at Kermiggy. Oh, yes, Kim, congratulations. I'm sure they're here somewhere. I'll send them a request. There's so many people in this space. It's oh, I got a request. And added speaker. Connecting. Kim is connecting. Give Kim a second. Okay, go.
Hello. And thank you so much for this win. I am ecstatic. I'm so happy. Is this working?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, good. Sorry, sometimes it lags for me. I have really bad Wi-Fi, but yeah, and I also love all the people who were nominated with me, and you also deserve to win, but I'm glad that I did. Thank you.
Congratulations, Kim. Okay, so I'm just doing my behind-the-scenes work. It's a lot of work that goes into this. Anyway, you know, I like the Muppets. I of course I do. I like the Muppets. But I could never force myself to watch everything they ever made. Like, that is a crazy lifetime commitment that nobody in their right mind should do. Well, anyway, please welcome the host of Kermitment, Mathew Gaydos and Sam Schultz.
Hello. Hello, are we coming in? Matt, I think they can hear us. Hello, Muppet Twitter Awards. This is Matt and Sam.
But not the Matt and Sam you know. We are the Matt and Sam from 2123.
And we've come from the far future. A lot has changed.
We're on episode 5,281 of Kermitment. We just discovered the fifth episode of the second season of the third Dinosaurs reboot.
It's a sexy teen murder drama. Actually, everything is a sexy teen murder drama in the year 2123, but it's pretty good.
And Disney finally cracked the technology and created real, walking, talking, living, breathing Muppets.
And they even have their own show every week called The Neo Muppet Show.
They actually let us visit the set recently, and Sam got to live out his lifelong wish. He got to bite Neo Rolf's nose. Unfortunately, he was mauled really badly in the process.
Yeah, side effect of the Muppet creation process was that all the Neo Muppets have razor-sharp teeth for some reason.
But we didn't travel through time to just talk about Neo Muppets or the sexy Dinosaurs reboot. No, we are here with a dire warning.
That's right, Matt. In the future, the Muppets No Context Twitter account has become self-aware and rules the human race with an iron fist.
We've determined that the account became conscious during this very awards ceremony at the exact moment Sam and I read the winner of this year's official Muppets Twitter account.
So we've been traveling through time, taking actions that we hope will change the winner today and alter the course of your future for the better.
Okay, so a lot hangs in the balance here. The nominees for Best Official Muppet Twitter Account are The Great Gonzo, Rizzo the Rat, Grover, Miss Piggy, Elmo, No McNeil, The Count, and Kirk R. Thatcher.
Oh boy.
And the winner in this timeline is... Oh no. It's Gonzo the Great.
No.
Again.
Is there any timeline not tainted by the tyrannical rule of the Muppets No Context Twitter account?
Wait. Sam.
What?
Did you hear that?
Oh no, they found us.
We have to go.
We have to go. I'm good so luck, sorry we couldn't fix this for you.
Thank you guys for trying. That's all I can say. And obviously Gonzo could not be here tonight, and I think we're a little glad he's not. But thank you two for both presenting tonight. Well, anyway, our next this is a really bad pun. Wait till you hear this. Our next presenter is not Shot E, but he is one Muppetational guy. Get it? No? Okay. Please welcome Tough Pigs' resident doer of things and stuff, Shane Keating. I sent Shane a request. These things take time, people. We're gonna... Okay, Shane Keating! Duty how?
Is it not working?
I can hear you.
Oh, great. I didn't realize we had to plan a whole bit like that. You expect me to follow a time travel story?
I didn't know that was happening.
I'm hearing a delay right now, so because I'm using my laptop and my phone.
Oh, goodness. I didn't know that was going to happen, Shane. Just
okay, I got to take that out. Okay, so here we go. I'm here to present the award for most affection towards a Muppet or Muppet performer. Isn't that nice? And the nominees are Amie, a.k.a. Princess Muppet, towards Jim Henson. What a guy. Millie, a.k.a. Trix Abby, towards Abby Kadabby. Huh, I guess so. Iffy, a.k.a. Bert Ernie, towards Bert and Ernie. Oh, I get that. Puppet Girl of the Day towards every female puppeteer. Emma Chandler towards Rolf the Dog, who wouldn't. And finally, the hosts of Muppeturgy towards Droop. What a guy. And, believe it or not, the winner is... Iffy towards Bert and Ernie. Hooray!
I don't think Iffy is here, unfortunately.
Oh. Oh no!
But I'm sure if they were, they'd be very happy about this award. Am I wrong? Is Iffy here? I'm looking. There's a lot of people in this space, y'all. But
well, it's not me.
Well, you're not secretly Iffy, Shane.
I should hope not.
Hmm. Yeah. Well, anyway, I'm sure Iffy would love this award, and thank you, Shane, for reading it out.
Well, thank you. Where's the food?
The chicken parm sandwiches are being shipped to you right now.
Hot diggity dang.
Okay. Our next little bit, I gotta pull up a thing on my computer because our next bit is actually a pre-recorded bit. Our guests sadly couldn't be here live because where they are right now, it is 1 o'clock in the morning, and apparently sleep is more important than our little award show. So anyway, please enjoy this pre-recorded message from Muppetsational's own Jade Turner.
Hello, this is Jade here from Muppetsational. I'm very excited this evening to be announcing the award for best merchandise. The nominees are Muppet Lego minifigures, Sam and Friends, the history of Jim's first television show, The Muppets Christmas Carol 30th Anniversary Sweater, Labyrinth Hot Sauce Collection by Jade City Foods, Disney The Muppets and Colourpop Holiday Collection, and Rainbow Connection Mini Lounge Fly Backpack. And the winner is Muppet Lego Minifigures! Yay!
Ah, thank you, Jade, very much. The Lego Corporation sadly did not... get my letter in the mail. Also, just a reminder, to speak in a space, you must be on a phone. You cannot be on a tablet or computer. Just weird. I don't know why. Let's see. I lost my place. Oh no. Who's next? Ah, good. They're next. Some of us love Jim Henson, but some of us like really, really, really like really love Jim Henson, including this next presenter. Please welcome Amie from Princess Muppet. Go.
Okay, is it working?
Yes.
Okay, good. Sorry. Hi, guys. Thank you for that lovely introduction. I am presenting the award today for Muppet Fan Sight of the Year. The nominees are Tough Pigs, The Muppet Wiki, Muppet Stuff, and Ernie and Bertle. And the winner is The Muppet Wiki! Congratulations!
I meant to unmute myself, and I muted myself. Congratulations, Muppet Wiki. If anybody from the Muppet Wiki would like to hop on the microphone and give a little speech, you're more than welcome to. And go!
Hey, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you. Go ahead.
Oh, terrific. Thank you so much. Thank you. My name's Scott Hansen, by the way. I co-founded Muppet Wiki with Danny Horn back in 2005. We're just two of hundreds of people who have contributed to Muppet Wiki over the years. Very happy to be doing what we do. Excited for everything that's coming soon, and want to thank everybody for your support. Thank you.
Congratulations. We'll hear more from Muppet Wiki later in the show when they receive the Lifetime Achievement Award. So we'll hear more from them later. Thank you very much, Scott, and thank you very much, Amie, for doing that lovely speech. Okay, now we get into something. Oh, wait. Oops. I lost my place again. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay, where was I? Yes, okay. Not every fan community has a resident seamstress, but Muppet Twitter definitely does. Here she is, the master of Muppet Twitter seamstress, Emily Engel.
Hey, I'm sure everybody is so stoked to hear from me tonight. And I'm actually knee deep in a Bruins game. So I am going to make this as quick as possible. But I am very, very pleased to be able to give my little speech here to present this wonderful award. Everyone can hear me, right? That's the thing?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, got it. All right, so this is what I wrote. Last spring, Holly got in touch with me to take an online quiz for her research paper. Since it had to do with the Muppets, I was all for it. I found myself faced with a series of questions about Kermit as a leader and employer. And boy, was I surprised by the results. Misconceptions in regard to Kermit's personality and workspace demeanor were quickly thrown back in my face. The idea that he was a wholly benevolent and meek leader was proven wrong after being shown clips of him on The Muppet Show, being crass, demeaning, and downright rude occasionally. The bottom line was that it further proved the Muppets, like us, have flaws, inconsistencies, and real personalities. Holly's 61-page thesis takes a deep dive into the, quote, remembered impressions of Kermit the Frog as a communicator and leader, comparing those perceptions to his demonstrated behaviors and seek to better understand the implications of their malalignment to identify and influence ways of being a more competent and effective communicator and leader, end quote. With that, we celebrate the usage of Muppets as an educational tool, and proudly award Holly Jones with what I like to call the Dr. Bunsen Honeydew Award of Academic Excellence Involving the Muppets. Congratulations, Holly.
And please welcome Holly Jones.
Thank you. It's great to be here. I'm very grateful for this honor. This research wouldn't have happened without the Muppet fan community. I am so grateful for Emily, who was so willing to not only take that survey, but to help share it out among the community, and to everybody who responded with their perceptions of Kermit as a communicator and leader, and their honesty and support. I'm absolutely grateful for this, and that Gonzaga University stood behind me all the way, and we were able to coin the phrase cura amphibious as part of the Jesuit tradition of education. I am just aghast with excitement tonight, and am so grateful for you all. So thank you for this honor, and thank you for those kind words, Emily.
Thank you, Emily, for those very kind words, and congratulations again to Holly Jones for her special achievement, Muppy, tonight. There's a lot of people listening, and I'm just trying to find our next presenters in the sea of people. Found them, okay, I invited them to speak, and now their introduction. Sometimes you just feel like you need to shout out the public domain, or maybe you think to yourself, it took two people to write that song? Well, I know these guys say that stuff a lot. So please welcome noted Joe Raposo stands and Muppeturgy host David Levy and Adam Grossworth.
Hey, hi everyone. Thank you, Tori, for inviting us to be a part of today's event. Wait for Adam to unmute. How are you doing, Adam? Adam can't hear us, and I can only hear myself. So I'm going to keep talking in the hope that Adam will hear us.
Hi, I'm back. Can you hear me?
Go.
Yes.
Yeah, we're good. Go.
It said I was a speaker, but also I lost everything. I couldn't hear you. Everything went away. Hello. Hi.
Just like an average night on Muppeturgy. Anyway, I'm David Levy.
I'm Adam Grossworth. And we are two of the four hosts of Muppeturgy, everyone's second favorite Muppet podcast.
That's right. You may also remember us from last year's Muppy Awards, where we swept.
David, we didn't win anything last year.
Oh, I know, but I swept my living room while we were listening to Tough Pigs collect all their trophies.
Oh, well, by that logic, next year we're going to drink the awards.
Woohoo! Anyway, I say, if you can't beat them, join them, which is why this year we are presenting the award for Best Tough Pigs Article.
The one category in which we can be sure the winner will be a Tough Pig.
And listen, we're not bitter. We love Tough Pigs. In fact, all four hosts of Muppeturgy have appeared on various Tough Pigs podcasts. And in fact, both Adam and I have been crowned Toughest Pig on episodes of Hubba Wah.
Good job. Besides, we're not here to win awards. We are here to win audience members, which I am not so sure we're being very successful at with this bit. So let's get on with the category. The nominees in the category of Best Tough Pigs Article are...
This Is Not a Fun Article About Muppets by Ryan Rowe.
Who Is Jim Hansen by J.D. Hansel.
The Fraggle Foodie, Doozer Six by Beth Cook.
Am I a Muppet Fan First by Jared Fairclough.
Why a Muppet Family Christmas is the Greatest Christmas Thing Ever by Mathew Sobermen.
Which Muppet Should Pete Davidson Date by Jared Fairclough.
Dog Person, an interview with Barkley performer R. Bruce Connolly by Ryan Rowe.
And Pride Month, Please Don't Assume I'm Straight or That I'm Not a Muppet Nerd by Stacey Rosen.
And the winner is...
Why a Muppet Family Christmas is the greatest Christmas thing ever by Mathew Soberman.
Congratulations, Mathew.
Congratulations, Mathew.
Congratulations on the host of Muppeturgy for pulling that off. Matt, I sent you a, all right. Oh no. Go.
Wow. I genuinely did not expect to win considering there were so many great articles this year. I want to thank my editors, first and foremost, Joe Hennis, Ryan Rowe, and reluctantly Jared Fairclough. I want to thank everybody who was involved in the creation of A Muppet Family Christmas. I want to thank the holiday of Christmas in general for giving me a reason to write this article. This is the third version of this that I've written. I can't believe that I've been allowed to keep this going and let it increasingly go off the rails over the years. So thank you to everyone who voted for me. I genuinely appreciate it, and I can't wait to show you what we're doing next.
Well, congratulations, Mathew. Okay, so sometimes you get a guest, you book a guest for something, and you just got to tell everybody, because it's so cool. You got this guest. And sometimes the guest is so cool that you tell nobody because you can't wait to hear everyone's reaction at the after party. So please welcome Trilo, Doc Hogg, and Louie himself, Tyler Bunch! Tyler, you're muted. Technical difficulties here, folks. If you... Here, I can try to... You might be talking, but you're muted. We'll work this out. Hold on. Give it a second. Send him a message. You might see that. Okay, hold on. Oh, okay, so he... Hold on. All right, now go. Are you there? Hold on. Can anybody else hear? Is it just me? Can I just not hear him? Or can anybody? Can anybody hear him? Okay, so that's thumbs down. Can people hear me? Okay. Tyler, are you there? Okay, so people can hear me, just not Tyler Bunch. Goodness. Oh, goodness. I don't know what to do now. All right, yeah, try leaving and coming back. We're gonna just give that a moment. I'm gonna sorry about this. Okay. Okay, we're gonna try this again. Tyler, can you speak? It says he's muted.
Now it says Mike is on. Can you
we're
hear
good.
Me?
We can hear you.
Oh
okay,
my please. Goodness. And I'm normally the most tech savvy dude in the green room at Sesame Street. I don't know what the hell just happened. This is freaking ridiculous.
Please welcome Muppet legend Tyler Bunch.
Muppet and apparently doesn't have the welcome to the fact that this is the first space I've ever been involved in. And that's pretty obvious from my tech idiocy. For those of you who don't know who I am, like he said, Bear in the Big Blue House or any inappropriate Muppet that's been canceled or any Muppet that Bill Beretta just decided he didn't want to do anymore. So I'm here today to present, you know, funny stuff. And isn't it appropriate that this was so hilarious? I don't know if you guys noticed with the regular Fleshy Awards, it seems like there's this ridiculous UK invasion. What I mean is, whenever I'm watching these awards and there are these performances that I truly enjoyed or characters that I've fallen in love with, and the actor walks up in front of the microphone and he's speaking in some bizarre UK dialect that I had no idea this person was from there. all of a sudden it feels like everybody accepting an award is from freaking Ireland or England. So for both the fact that there is the UK invasion happening on Sesame Street right now with Warwick being there much more regularly than probably any of us wants him to be. That's a joke. And also in an homage to the Fleshy Award system, and I call them the Fleshies versus the Puppets, but you guys probably heard me say that before. The rest of this presentation, I will be from the UK. So here we are. I'm about to present the award for funniest Muppet Twitter user. Laughter that you always want to get is the silent laughter of individuals simply plucking like on your witticisms going out into the Twitter sphere. And the people that have done that most successfully are JD Hansel, JD11PC, Sweetums Muppet, Shane O'Keating, Sock Drawer, otherwise known as Jared Faircloth, Jazz Faircloth, Mary Muppet Mulany, Out of Context Fraggle Rockers, OOC Fraggle GC for some reason, Gav, Gavry 3, and of course, Muppet History, very cleverly giving their at as History Muppet. And the winner of the funniest Muppet Twitter user, the funniest individual who's never actually heard a laugh at any of their jokes, Muppet History, ladies and gentlemen, at History Muppet. So darn hilarious. Are they here?
No, I don't think Josh is here. I believe Josh is currently working right now.
What a twat. All right, that's fine. I guess we'll forgive him for that. Whatever.
Thank you very much, British Tyler Bunch.
I'm so happy that finally worked out. And it's British Tyler Bunch that's really horrible with techie devices. The American Tyler Bunch is actually very good with the tech stuff.
Sure. Oh, that was great. Thank you so much, our very special guest, Tyler Bunch, for that excellent thing. And sorry again about the technical difficulties. They're going to happen again. Okay, so like, man, I would hate to be the idiot who has to follow Tyler freaking Bunch. So who's next? Oh, I'm that idiot. Well, anyway, here are the nominees for Best Parody Account. And the nominees are Brian Henson at Hi, I'm Brian Henson. Puppet Comedy Facts from Swamp TV at Puppet Comedy. A Bad Henson Restaurant at Bad Henson Bistro. One Muppetsational Shot at One Muppet Shot. Muppet News at The Muppet News. And Talking Houses at Muppet Houses. And the winner, I actually have this in an envelope here. I'm opening the envelope, and you can see the winner right here. I'm holding up the envelope with the winner. You guys can't see. Oh, this is an audio medium. Forget that. The winner is Brian Henson at Hi, I'm Brian Henson. I do not believe that Brian, the Hi, I'm Brian Henson account is here tonight, but I'm sure that person is both very confused and very happy that they won the award tonight. A lot of mixed reactions going on here tonight. Anyway, I'm getting back to my script now because I had to go to the list of the winners. Okay. There are very few people in this life that I have talked to about Cookie Monster for several hours. And funny enough, both of them are here today. So please welcome the host of Muppet Profiles, Carrie and Justin. Again, I'm inviting them to speak. Oh, okay. Are they from one account, or can I just not find the other account?
We're on one account.
Okay, perfect. Go.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Thank you, Tori, for inviting us. I'm your presenter, Carrie.
And I'm your presenter, Justin.
Go ahead.
Tonight, we're here to present for the award of the best debut character.
All right. They are Lyle Craggle from Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock, Pogi Fraggle from Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock, Jambolin the Troubadour, Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock, Blurf, Muppet Babies, Gonzi and the Morpets from Kermitment, and Marty Soul from Sesame Street.
And the winner is Jim Bolin, the troubadour, Fraggle Rock, back to the rock.
Thank you, too, for presenting that. Sadly, David Diggs did not answer any of my calls. darn. But yeah, congratulations to Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock for, I think, their first award of the night. I'm not sure. We'll see how many they rack up as we go through. But we reached the somber moment of our show. Before we get into our next award, I would like to take a quick moment to remember Emilio Delgado and Bob McGrath. They were both legendary Sesame Street human performers who we sadly lost last year. They both meant so much to this community, and I would like to take a quick moment of silence to remember them. Thank you so much, Bob and Emilio, and thank you for everything. On a lighter note, our next presenter is a familiar voice to everyone in this space, as he was our first winner tonight and our opening act. And I owe him money, so that's why he's here. I'm doing him a favor. So please welcome back Muppet fan artist extraordinaire, Richard Michael Gomez. Just waiting on Richard. And Richard's here. So go, Richard.
That is correct. The only reason I'm the only way she could get me back is it's a monetary exchange, pretty much. Anyhow, it's a pleasure to do this little nomination. We've got some wonderful folks queued up for hold on. I need to find the nomination again. Sorry. For the best host of a Muppet themed podcast. Our first nominations are Mathew, Gaydos, and Sam Schultz of Kermitment, Matt Vogel of Below the Frame, Jade Turner, Emma Chandler, and Louis Chandler of Muppetational, Becca Petunia, Hubba-wa? Ryan Rowe and Anthony Strand, moving right along, David Levy, Adam Grossworth, Christy Bauer, and Michael Richardson of Muppeturgy, Tori of Live from Muppetland, who's that? Mary, Maria, and Sprout of Muppet Fans Talking. And, do I just say the winner?
Yes.
Okay, I am thrilled to announce that the winner is Matt Vogel of Below the Frame! Yay! A wonderful
congratulations. Muppet
performer and co-worker to Tyler Bunch, who is here with us.
Yes! Congratulations to Matt Vogel. Obviously, Matt could not be here tonight, but I'm sure if he was, he'd be very excited for this award. And thank you, Richard,
Sorry, who's your favorite Matt Vogel character?
I guess Uncle Deadly.
Okay, that's a good pick. Mine's the ape angel. It's got a whole Muppet Wiki would know, or Shane, but I don't remember the whole title right now. Tyler probably knows.
Richard, what are you talking about?
Get Muppet Wiki to send it to you.
Okay, Richard, you okay. We'll hear from Richard never. Okay, I gotta find my script again. You know, I quite enjoy food. I do. I mean, who doesn't like a good food? You know, so much so, I even made a terrible sandwich with Joe Hennis that one time. And Joe can tell you about how bad that was. But this next person, or this next presenter, is quite the foodie. Or more accurately, a Fraggle foodie. Please welcome Tough Pig's own trash heap translator, Beth Cook.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me here tonight. I am here to present the award for Best Fan Video or Video Series. And the nominees are More Lost Brian Henson Intros, The Making of the Great Muppet Mural, April Fool's The Not So Great Muppet Mural, Animation Look Back, The Muppets, Part 1 through 3, Richard Gomez's Puppet Videos, and Emily Engel's Making of Dr. Teeth. And the winner is Emily Engel's Making of Dr. Teeth. Congratulations.
Congratulations. I think Emily left to go watch the Bruins game. Is Emily still here? Because I think Emily... Oh, Emily left to go watch the Bruins game. Oh, my goodness. She's going to be so mad that she... Oh, I'm sure... That's too funny. That is too funny. Is Emily here? And I'm just missing it. Nope. I think she went to go watch the Bruins game. Well, thank you, Beth, for that wonderful congratulations to Emily, who is probably kicking herself right now. Our next presenter is our final pre-recorded guest. This presenter did want to be here, but they had a previously scheduled commitment. He is one heck of a guy, and I've even heard he's one heck of a singer. So please welcome, live via several hours ago, Tough Pigs' own head writer, Ryan Rowe.
Me. No, I'm not doing my Beaker impression. I'm warming up. Hi, this is Ryan from toughpigs.com. I'm here to present the award for Best Song. First, I will tell you about the nominees, so please listen closely because they are these. Glow Away from Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock. One Heart from Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock. Party at Fraggle Rock from Fraggle Rock Back to the Rock. What, again? Chase the Wind from Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock. I'm sensing a pattern here. Magic Be With You from Fraggle Rock, Night of the Lights. Ah. And When Love Is Gone from the D23 Muppet Christmas Carol panel. Now I'll tell you the winner, so don't change the channel. The award goes to When Love Is Gone from the D23 Muppet Christmas Carol panel. Thank you. And congratulations to the winner and all the nominees.
Thank you, pre-recorded Ryan Rowe. That's my favorite type of Ryan Rowe. And Jody Benson also did not take my calls. So our next award is the special Muppy going to Behind the Mayhem, which a few times I might have called Beyond the Mayhem. I don't know how to spell. I'm sorry. And one of the mods of this award, one of the mods of Behind the Mayhem is my friend Mel. And I told Mel that I would be presenting this award. Well, Mel, I'm sorry, but I told a fib. Please welcome back the co-creator of the upcoming Disney Plus original series, Muppet Mayhem, Jeff Yorks. You can speak now.
I was on mute. I'm still Jeff Yorks. And along with Adam F. Goldberg and Bill Beretta, I'm one of the creators of the upcoming Disney Plus show, The Muppets Mayhem. So, you know, within Muppet fandom, there are subsets, as you all know. You got your Fraggle Rockers, your Fozzie fans, also known as the Waka Flock, your Emmett Otter Squad, your Beaker Freakers, Swine Trekkies or Swine Trekkers. And if you're a fan of the Electric Mayhem, like I am, you're what we on the Muppets Mayhem refer to as a Mayhead. And it takes a very special Muppet fan to be a Mayhead. You have to be groovy, you have to break the rules, and you have to rock. Well, this past year, a bunch of Mayheads came together to make the Electric Mayhem fanzine Behind the Mayhem. And it is every inch all those things more. You know, put together by Mel, a.k.a. What Mel Draws, and Sarah, a.k.a. Kiwi Cartwheels, and Rocky, a.k.a. Rockabilly Bun. Behind the Mayhem is page after page of Technicolor tribute with 40 of my now favorite artists literally illustrating their Electric Mayhem. Each piece is a psychedelic surprise and delight and kind of freaked me out a little because somehow, I thought maybe our show maybe leaked online because you guys captured some incredible and oddly very specific moments in there, but we'll get to that when the show comes out. And the best part is that all the proceeds were for charity. and nothing rocks harder than doing good. So it's truly everything our show aspires to be. And speaking on behalf of members, thank you to all the Mayheads who helped make it. It is my honor to present the absolutely special Muppy to the mods behind the Mayhem.
Wow, thank you so much. I didn't expect all this. I thought I would come on and I was going to be like, well, all right, and shout at everybody. But thank you so much, Jeff. You took the words out of my mouth. We had 40 other wonderful, amazing artists who, honestly, I consider them all rock stars. They dedicated their time and talent to just making all of this mayhem. And thank you, too. I was definitely going to shout you out because you actually purchased the zine, which is incredible, and we really appreciate it, of course. And oh my goodness, I'm kind of all a flutter now.
I told you, I'm a fan first, so of course yeah. I'm going to buy it.
Yeah, it's of fantastic. Course, thank you. And yeah, thank you so much again to Sarah and Rocky and everyone else, of course, who bought the zine and helped us support, like the charity Save the Music Foundation, and also just make this tribute to the band really special. And yeah, that's all. And thank you too, Tori, for running the Muppet Awards. I wanted to shout you out, of course, too. And one more thing, sorry. And thank you to the Muppet performers, the Muppet Studios, and the entire cast of Muppets Mayhem. And that's all. I'm done. Sorry. Thank you.
Congratulations again to Mel, Sarah, and Rocky, and the behind the beautiful Behind the Mayhem fanzine for their special achievement Muppy Award. And thank you again, Jeff Yorks, for popping on and saying some very kind and very great things. Next up, okay, again, a lot of people in the space, and there's just a lot of people to find. But anyway, next we get to highlight one of my favorite and one of the smaller accounts here on MuppeTWT. They were nominated tonight for the award Best Account Under 1,000 Followers, so please welcome Karsten from Pig's Laundry.
Hello, hi. It's really lovely to be here. I just love that this community is, like, relatively small, but it's, like, it's so vast in a way. It's just like, I don't know. Everybody here is so cool. I love you. And so I am presenting, hold on, I need to find the thing. Okay. I'm presenting Best Muppet Twitter Moment. And the nominees are Oscar and Cookie Monster addressing Twitter's downfall, Elmo versus Rocco, the second annual MuppetMet Gala, The Morpits, Jim Henderson, Janice somehow beating Lamb Chop in the Puppet Girls bracket, Kendall Roy, Hansen character poll. Okay, and the winner is Elmo versus Rocco.
Ah, yes, the thing that invaded Twitter for an entire month last January. Thank you, Karsten, for reading out the nominees. And before we get into our next award, somebody who actually won an award finally came back to the space. So please, to give an acceptance speech, here is Emily Engel.
I am so sorry. I honestly didn't think I was going to win that one. And I am thrilled that I did. To be totally honest, the Bruins versus Maple Leafs game is really, really intense. So that's kind of why I left. Thank you so much for that award. I am really stunned because I am the worst video editor ever. But I am really glad I got to make a time-lapse video so you guys can actually see what I do when I make a replica. And I'm honored. This is a big deal for me. Thank you again. And Tori, thank you for letting me get back on the air for a minute because I'm a big dope who left.
No problem. Thank you for coming back.
Thanks.
Sorry for that interruption. I just felt, you know what? She came back and she gets the sayest thing real quick. So some people, a lot of people campaigned during this Muppy season, but I don't think anybody campaigned as hard as our next presenter, who I am desperately trying to find in the list of people right now. I just sent them a request. So please welcome the person who I think campaigned more than anybody else, Kim from @kermiggy, who I did send a request, but they do have Wi-Fi issues. So, okay. Go, Kim.
Hello. So I am here to present the most wild on MuppeTWT, which is Such a fun little category. I love when you guys act insane. It makes me feel more safe. So the nominees are Amie at Princess Muppet, B at Swift Beatles, Richard Michael Gomez at Starman's Art, Gav at Gavry 3, Emily Engel at BX Personified, Arnold Muncho, Nova at Melanated Muppet, and Boober Memes at Memes Boober. And the winner is Richard Michael Gomez!
Woo! I want to hear what Richard's about to say. Oh, Richard, come on and accept your award. Come on, Richard. Oh, and Kim, thank you very much, Kim, for that excellent presentation. Come on, Richard. We know you've got something to say about this, Richard. All right, go ahead.
My internet pooped a little bit there. Can everybody hear me?
I can hear you.
I'm seeing a lot of thumbs down. I'm assuming that's just because my friends like
that's
to,
just because people
like
are mad.
Bully me a little bit. But I wasn't expecting to do anything again. I'd like to thank the ape dressed as an angel singing about acorns that appeared in Sesame Street in episode 4000. Wait, no, that's not correct. in episode 4225, not 4000. I promise to be even more insane in 2023. You have more fake mustaches, more toupees. I'm gonna do drag. You're gonna
go, you're Richard.
Gonna see, what's wrong with drag, Tori? You're gonna see my.
Puppet. I said go.
Go. Oh, go. Leave now. What's going on?
No, like go, Richard. Like yay, Richard.
Oh, okay, great. I'm glad that you don't have anything against drag. I'm gonna take even more puppets and more consorts. I'm planning on ambushing Father John Misty two more times in April. He'll think he has a stalker. It'll be great. I think that's all the time we have. Thank you so much for voting for me. I don't know why you did. Thank you.
Congratulations again, Richard.
Thank you.
I don't know. Yes, congratulations, Richard. Oh goodness, I keep losing my place. So did you know that toughpigs.com has an About Us page? And did you also know that the About Us page is really funny for some reason, and each Tough Pigs has a funny little title? So please welcome Tough Pigs' official director of time travel, Mathew Sobermen.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I just came back. I think they sent me to the wrong thing. They sent me to 1923, which, there was no robot apocalypse there. In fact, there really wasn't anything Muppety there at that point. But, Before we hand out the award for Best Gimmick Account, I do want to talk to you about one of my favorite TV shows. It was really popular in the 70s and early 80s. Millions of people watched it around the world. I'm, of course, talking about MASH. On the television show MASH, the character Charles Emerson Winchester once said, "I do one thing at a time, I do it very well, and then I move on." But while these eight Twitter accounts do one thing very well, like Muppet Lab's super adhesive to Gilda Radner, they stick to what works again and again. Whether it's through images, video clips, GIFs, the written word, or whatever's going on with the Fraggle Rockers, these accounts celebrate the world of Jim Henson on a daily basis, and that's no gimmick. The nominees for Best Gimmick Account are Muppet Quotes at Muppet Quotes, Out of Context Fraggle Rockers at OOC Fraggle Rock GC. I'm sorry, no. OOC Fraggle GC. Puppet Girl of the Day at Puppet Girl OTD. Muppet GIF of the Day at GIFs _ of _ puppets. Henson Creature of the Day at Henson Creature. No Context Jim Henson at No _ Muppets. Muppet Pictures at Muppet Pictures, and Boober Fraggle Daily at Daily Boober. And the Muppy goes to Muppet GIF of the Day at GIFs underscore of Puppets.
Congratulations, I sent you an invite to speak, and thank you, Mathew Soberman, for that wonderful monologue.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Go
ahead.
Wow.
Thank you all for this. I probably can make a glorious 3-hour speech, but I'll make it a minute and a half. Thank you all again for voting for me, for everyone who follows me and enjoys my stuff. It really means a lot. And, you know, if my gifts have brought you any, you know, extra joy into your life in these profoundly weird times that we're living in, there can be, you know, no better reward than that. Although this comes as a very close second, obviously. I want to thank, I have so many people that, so I'm just going to run through. Tough Pigs, Muppet Wiki, Muppet History, Carrie and Justin at Muppet Profiles, Tori. I'm blanking on people, but you know who you are. Everybody who makes GIFs and shares them and lets me share them. Everyone who was nominated in this category and all the other categories, because you all add something wonderful to this community, and I'm glad that you're all here and you make this place a better place. And finally, thank you to the Muppets, because you're awesome, and for whatever reason, you make great reaction GIFs. So thank you all very much.
And thank you, Sam. Okay. So, you know, I'd like to think that I am able to go anywhere and everywhere. But our next guest is stuck where he is because he will never get out of the cube. Please welcome the sovereign of the bad Hansen world and Tough Pig's master of Hansen holidays, J.D. Hansel.
Thanks, Tori. You know, the international tradition of the Muppets Twitter Awards has been celebrating the talents and hard work of the Muppet performers since its inception over 10 months ago, and I am honored to announce one of tonight's winners. The nominees for Best Muppet Performer of 2023 are Karen Prell as Red Fraggle, Icy Joe, and more in Back to the Rock, John Tartaglia as Gobo Fraggle, Sprocket, and more in Back to the Rock, Dave Goals and Frank Meshkelite as Boober Fraggle, Uncle Traveling Matt, and World's Oldest Fraggle in Back to the Rock, Jordan Lockhart as Wembley Fraggle and others in Back to the Rock, Donna Kimball as Monkey Fraggle, Cotter Pinduzer, and others in Back to the Rock, Dan Garza as the face, voice, and soul of Junior Gorg in Back to the Rock, and Matt Vogel as Kermit the Frog in Best in Snow. The excellence of these puppeteers and their performances shows the value of having one performer dedicated to each Muppet character, except when they break the rules and don't do it that way. Tonight, this award is a testament to how these incredible performers can work together to bring our favorite characters to life. The winners of this year's award for Best Muppet Performer are Dave Goals as the voice and Frank Meshkelite as the puppeteer of Boober Fraggle, Uncle Matt, and more on Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock. To give them a special round of applause, everybody send that 100 emoji. Just click the red one just to shake things up. Let me see them. There we go. Thank you. Back to you, Tori.
Thank you, JD. Obviously, Dave and Frank, could not be here tonight, but I'm sure they're both very happy if they found out that this thing was happening. I'm sure they'd be very happy that they got an award. Our next presenter was somebody who about 5 minutes ago won an award. So please welcome back Sam from Muppet GIF of the Day.
Thank you, Tori. It's great to be back. Feels like I never left. Forgive me if I'm going out on a limb here, but I think it's fair to say that based on everything we've done here tonight, that I think a few of us here are Muppet fans.
What?
I know, right? It's crazy. I myself am a Muppet fan. I'm very proud of that, which is why it is such an honor for me to be here
to celebrate one very special Muppet and proclaim that Muppet to be Muppet of the Year, which could be considered an insult in some corners of the globe, but here on Muppet Twitter is one of the highest honors that we can bestow. The eight Muppets nominated in this category, or more accurately, the seven Muppets and one Pet Rock nominated in this category are Abby Cadabby, The Great Gonzo, Boober Fraggle, Kermit the Frog, Robin the Frog, Rocco, Bear, and Animal. And the winner is... That's weird. It says Charles Dickens. Oh, it must mean the Great Gonzo. Congratulations, Gonzo, for being named Muppet of the Year 2 years in a row. I don't know if it's a feat that can top dancing in a vat of oatmeal or eating a rubber tire to the tune of Flight of the Bumblebee, but it's a pretty great feat nonetheless. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Gonzo, and congratulations, Sam, for not getting murdered by Gonzo. Good, good, good. We beat the curse, folks. We beat the curse. So, I got a question. Why are Muppets fans so darn talented? Like, there are way too many talented people in this fandom. Like, between the Tough Pigs writers and the Twitter users and the podcasters, there's just too much talent to go around. And don't even get me started on the fan artists. All of them are just way too talented. Heck, even our next presenter is a way too talented fan artist. Please welcome Christio.
Hello. First off, thank you, Tori, so much for inviting me to present. You're very kind. I am Christio, or KO Makes Things, and I am presenting Best Production because I could not be trusted to present Best Merch, as I definitely would have declared Labyrinth Hot Sauce as Best Merch regardless of the number of votes it actually received. For Best Production of 2022, our nominees are Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock, Season 1, Muppet Babies, Season 3, Episode 30, The Muppet Babies Show Series Finale, Fraggle Rock, Night of Lights, The Sesame Street Off-Broadway Musical, Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio, and Sesame Street, Season 53. And our winner for Best Production is Fraggle Rock, Back to the Rock, Season 1.
Yay! Of course it was Fraggle Rock. Why wouldn't it be Fraggle Rock? Congratulations to all the Fraggles and Canadians out there. You deserve it. And thank you so much, Christy, for reading that list of nominees. Shoot, now I need to find... Oh, I can't find them because they keep spamming the emojis. That's why I couldn't find them. So our next award is the Benny Vandergast Memorial Award. Why did I say it like that? I have no idea. Which is basically the Muppet equivalent of a Lifetime Achievement Award. Last year, this honor went to all the good folks at toughpigs.com. And so I thought it was only fitting for a Tough Pig to pass on this honor to the next recipient. So please welcome Tough Pig's very own head writer, Joe Hennis.
Hello, I am Joe Hennis from Tough Pigs, and for just a few minutes longer, we are the sole recipients of the Benny Vandergast Memorial Award. Today, I am very proud to be the presenter of this year's Benny Vandergast Memorial Award. Now, you may be wondering who Benny Vandergast is. Well, let me tell you, he's, I'm sorry, hang on one second, let me just check the Muppet Wiki. Oh, interesting. It's from the Jim Neighbors episode. That's kind of neat. I am certainly not alone in my reliance on the Muppet Wiki. It's been our source for literally every Tough Pigs article we've ever written, whether for confirmation about obscure character names, getting information about weird merchandise, or to read about any of the one of thousands of episodes of Sesame Street thanks to their episode guide that's already miles beyond what they have within the walls of Sesame Workshop. Also, they have information about that ape Angel from episode 4225. They've been the source of all information related to the Muppets and completely reliable thanks to an unbreakable system of dedicated admins and contributors. We literally would not be able to do what we do without them, and Muppet fandom as a whole would be much worse off. As many of you know, the Muppet Wiki and Tough Pigs share a common ancestor. Beyond the symbiotic relationship that we've built over the years, Muppet Wiki gets the facts, Tough Pigs broadcasts the opinions. That's just how it works. We were also founded by the same person, Danny Horn. Hi, Danny. I hope you're out there. That makes us brothers. And if Muppet fandom is centered around any one thing, it's family. With that in mind, I am very proud to present this year's Benny Vandergast Memorial Award to our friends, our library and encyclopedia, and our keeper of all knowledge, and our brothers in arms, the Muppet Wiki.
Please, anybody from the Muppet Wiki on the mod team or a part of the Muppet Wiki is more than welcome to hop up and get your moment in the sun.
Well, thank you very much. Again, apologies earlier for my weird acceptance speech. I wasn't expecting to go on so early. So, that was a little weird. If you missed it, my name is Scott Hansen. I co-founded Muppet Wiki with Danny Horn back in 2005. And it's fitting that Joe was the presenter, because Muppet Wiki really kind of started at Tough Pigs. It was Danny's website. For a few years, I had been doing a lot of research with Danny and technical support and that sort of thing. And we eventually started working on some articles together. And one of the big projects that we worked on was a comprehensive history of Grover's mom.
Groversmom.com.
That's right. Yeah. Hey, there's Danny.
Hey, how you doing, everybody?
So that turned into Danny and I were on a phone call one day, and he said to me,
I'm obsessed, and I have about 18 free years coming up. How about you?
Yeah, exactly. And I said, yeah, sure, let's do it. And we started Muppet Wiki, and here we are all these years later.
I'm proud to say that I wrote the first sentence, the brilliant first sentence on the wiki, which was Fozzie Bear is a bear.
Yeah. It's an iconic first line and factual.
It's true.
Yeah. Over the years, we've had hundreds, if not thousands of contributors. I really want to thank, all the admins who, work so hard to make sure that, everything on the, we're very much like Wikipedia. Anybody can contribute to it. But the admins really kind of, keep everything under control. We've been working on a lot of really fun and exciting things. We just celebrated our 17th anniversary last month. We just passed 41,000 articles just this past week. Hopefully coming up very soon within the year, I think we'll probably be finally finishing our Sesame Street episode guide, which is crazy, absolutely just bonkers to me that we're, there are over 4,500 episodes. And anyway, we'll get too much into that. But yeah, just want to say thank you. Danny and I fell in love with wikis. Everybody else who contributes to Muppet Wiki, clearly they fell in love with wikis. I'd like to invite anybody out there who is interested in collaborating with a bunch of awesome people to really make a better database that is accessible to fans and to researchers and to professionals. We've worked with some of the professionals to put this stuff together. I'll stop droning on and thank the Vandergast estate and thanks to everybody and congratulations to everybody who's been nominated and has won.
Yes, thank you all very much.
And once again, congratulations to the Muppet Wiki. I really couldn't even have done this show without Muppet Wiki, if I'm being completely honest. So this is just thank you, all the Muppet Wiki people, and I'm very happy that y'all got the second annual Benny Vandergast Memorial Award. So last year at the Muppies, most of our presenters were actually hosts of Muppet podcasts, funny enough. But all of the podcast awards were, like, the first awards listed. Like, that was, like, the first awards we did were all the podcast awards. So basically all of our presenters had already lost by the time it got to their turn. So everybody was kind of a little sad throughout the night. So tonight, I made sure to spread out the podcast awards and leave one of the biggest awards for last. So please welcome back the man who presented this award last year and the host of To Introduce Our Guest Star, Jared Fairclough.
Yes, yes. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here at the Can You Hear Me Awards. I find it interesting you said everyone was a bit sad by the end of it last time because people had lost, when I'm one of the last presenters and I've lost every award that I've been nominated for tonight. I lost Best Guest to Dave Goals. Fine. I lost Best Website to Muppet Wiki. Look, I get it. They're great. Funniest Muppet Twitter user to Muppet History. Moving on. Best Fan Video to Emily Engel. I get it. Best Tough Pigs Article to Matt Soberman. Look, we'll talk about it at his review. It's fine. I'm not going to go on about it. Best Muppet Theme Podcast is what I'll be presenting tonight. There sure are a lot of them. Just looking through the list here, we have 8 nominees. I've only been a guest on 2 of them and happened to lose an award for one of those appearances tonight. So I'm feeling wonderful about myself. Yes. I heard a joke the other day that I thought was fitting here, which was, what do you call a collection of white people? A podcast. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll give you all a moment to settle down and finish your applause for that joke. All right. So Best Muppet Theme Podcast. The nominees are Muppetsational. Haven't been asked to be on that. Below the Frame. Fun fact. I edited the first 3 episodes of that. Kermitment. Haven't been on that one either. Hubba-wa? That one I have been on. Didn't do well. Don't bother listening to it. Actually, listen to it, because it's a great podcast. Just don't listen to me, because I did terribly. Moving right along. Remember when I lost the award for that? Anyway. Fraggle Talk. Look, I didn't work on Fraggle Rock, so I'll let Joe go on that one. That's fine. Muppeturgy. Just checking my email. Nope, haven't been invited on that one either. And Muppet Profiles. Let me just double-check my DMs. No! Not that one either. Fantastic. I don't know if it's a thing because I'm an Australian. I don't know. I don't want to like feed into that. It's fine. But the winner for the Best Muppet Theme Podcast goes to Kermitment. Well done, gang.
I'm sending them the invite right now, Jared. Thank you for that absolutely wonderful speech.
It was a pleasure. I'd like to be nominated for it for next year. Thank you.
We'll see.
Ow. Zero. 0% thought we were winning that one. Sam?
I was really taking a big lean back and not expecting to speak one bit. But this is really nice.
I started making a graphic to post on our Twitter account. That said, Kermitment lost a bunch of Muppet Awards tonight. I just assumed we had already lost. Right? But thank you so much. yeah, that's amazing.
I don't even really know what to say. Thank you. That it's been great making the show and getting to know Matt better, I think, is one really special part of it. And like, learning about our friendship through the Muppets is a big part of it for me. And I'm just also very grateful that Matt does all the research and stuff too.
I have to mention that Sam does all the editing, which, number one tip, anyone with a podcast, you should edit your podcast. And we talk sometimes for up to 2.5 hours when we record episodes. So Sam is cutting out an hour of content at times. And when I go and listen to it, I don't even notice the things he cut out. So that just tells me Sam's doing a great job on our podcast. And apparently enough of you agreed that Sam's doing a great job editing our podcast to make us the Best Muppet Theme Podcast of the year.
Wow. Yeah, so thank you to everybody. And also thank you to our wives who put up with us watching four episodes of Fraggle Rock every Saturday night, or me at least.
Yep, I'm about to go do that right after this.
Mm-hmm, me too. Bye.
All right, you two go watch your Fraggle Rock, and congratulations again to Kermitment. Now, look at us. Here we are, right where we belong, at our final category tonight. And while I could have saved a surprise celebrity guest for this slot, I decided to end with one of the biggest names in the Muppet fandom. You heard him tonight. He was the creator of Muppet Zine, founder of Tough Pigs, and co-founder of Muppet Wiki. He now runs the blog Superheroes Every Day and the Twitter account Muppet Pictures. Please give a warm welcome to Muppet fan legend, Danny Horn.
Hi. Oh, that's great. Hi, everybody. I'm Danny Horn, first-time nominee. And I'm really happy to be here with you tonight. Now, I was kind of out of public Muppet life for a little while, mostly working on Muppet Wiki with Scott and everybody. But in the last couple of years, I've been making appearances on the Moving Right Along podcast. I've written a couple things for Tough Pigs here and there. And this year, I started this Twitter account, Muppet Pictures. And nobody told me that I was going to be ranked and rated and judged on who's the best at it. Like, I didn't know this was a competition. Back in my day, you were either associated with Tough Pigs and you were awesome, or you were associated with Muppetsational. And it was kind of, okay, but aside from that, though, everybody was equal and we were a big Muppet fan family. So, as I'm announcing this very special final award of the evening, I would like to take this moment to say that this award ceremony should not exist. And I dispute the premise of this entire concept. That being said, the nominees for Muppet Twitter User of the Year are Muppet Wiki, Tough Pigs, Muppet History at History Muppet, Richard Gomez, aka Starman's Art, Brian Hansen at Hi, I'm Brian Hansen, Becca Petunia, otherwise known as Uncle Petunio, Kim, aka Kermiggy, The Muppets No Concept, or no Context, at Muppets No. Iffy, also known as Birkinirny, and Bad Henson Restaurant, currently doing business as Bad Henson Bistro. And the winner of the final Muppie of the night is Muppet History at History Muppet. Congratulations. I believe they're not here, so if you don't mind, I'm just gonna kind of grab that. Thank you all very much. Have a good night.
Oh no! Somebody catch him! He's on the run. thank you very much, Danny, for that excellent final award of the night. And for the second year in a row, the final award goes to Muppet History. And for the second year in a row, he sadly cannot be here tonight. But you know, it happens. It is what it is. Anyway. Before we go, we have made it to here at the end of another one, folks, but there are a few people I gotta thank before we head out of this thing. Oof. I would like to thank all of our nominees and presenter tonight. The show could literally have not have happened without you. I do a lot of work, but y'all, thank you all to all of our presenters and all of our nominees. I want to shout out Sam Allen from Muppet Gift of the Day for surprising me with the lovely Muppet Twitter Awards website, and also for making some really cool category spotlight videos. Thanks again to my good buddy Richard Michael Gomez for singing that excellent opening number tonight and for creating the beautiful Muppet Awards logo. Thank you to Emily Engel for inspiring me to make the Muppet trophies. Thank you to Christy O for inspiring me to write a joke into my opening monologue. Thank you to everybody who gave me feedback for the awards, and a special, special, special thanks to everybody who shared, followed, liked the Muppet Twitter Awards in any way. I could not have done this award without everybody's support, and thank you all. If you want to keep the fun going, in about 2 minutes after I use the bathroom, I'm going to hop back on a different Twitter space, and we're going to have the Muppet Twitter Awards after party. It's completely optional. Anybody can come. It'll be a fun night if anybody wants to do that. I hope to do this next year. Hopefully Twitter still exists. And I will see you all later. Cue Muppet Show closing theme song.
Stanley?
Yeah, what?
Is that it?
Yes, it's over. How'd you like it?
I don't know. I slept through the whole thing.
Well, you didn't miss much.